the welder in there? He's welding in there. He's arc welding.
You see that? A little light come on, buddy?
Right in here. The Y at the center of the railroad, and it is a junction between the tourist railroad, the Lost Dutchman, and the Southern Pacific. It's August of 1967, and in an alternate history, the Southern Pacific, rather than just abandoning some of this trackage, they've spun it off. So the Creamery branch and the line to the north, as well as the Kyrene branch, have been sold to a tourist railroad called the Lost Dutchman. And the Southern Pacific still has the trackage between Phoenix and Chandler. And we've got on from this star, this three-pointed star, the three legs go that way. And in real life, it goes straight north across the Salt River and then turns left to go to Phoenix. We've got the block wall in the way, so we bent everything all around. So we go out that way across the Salt River. You see the bridge still under construction over there.
And as a quick reference where you're at, Gamage is right there.
You see?
In the big hole in the middle.
It's actually right over here.
Oh, it's over here?
Yeah.
Further back? I thought it was...
This is Mill Avenue.
Oh, okay. Because it curves around.
Gamage is actually down...
Further down?
This side over here is bent in. It should be out like that.
That.
Okay? So if you visualize that, this not being here, then... If you ran Mill Avenue straight down that way, the curve for Mill Avenue would be about at the end of the benchwork, and Gamage would be about where that blue box is.
Yeah.
Okay,
that would
be. Yeah, I'm basing everything on the mill. I forget that it curves around all the time.
Yes.
I'm looking at where the mill
is. Well, we've got, you know, we have the wall. There are two sections of the benchwork here that are actually oriented correctly north, south, east, west, which I had to have because, you know, I spent 40 years being oriented to direction,
yeah.
And that's what I did. So,
he's a pilot.
This is the north-south trackage through Tempe. There's the big curve down there where that gooseneck lamp is sitting, and that's next to the high school and the Tempe Hospital. And then the trackage goes straight east to Mesa. Mm-hmm. And those are correctly oriented, and it helps me. I know it sounds strange, but it really does help me keep me.
Yeah.
If it were twisted too much more, I'd probably go nuts. After it crosses over the river, we've placed the Tanner Brothers gravel pit operation over there. I don't know what the name of it was back when I was a kid, but this is a place I've got on the railroad, so I put it there. And then we come along over here. We can walk a little bit. If you look across here, you can see that. Yeah, industrial area there. That's called Tovrea. Tovrea was a family that ran a packing operation. So they had a very large, probably more than 100 chutes of cattle unloading stock pens. And then they had the very big slaughterhouse. And then they, you know, provided product for Patrick Cuddy Company. And it was pork as well as beef. And then off to the east a little ways was the co-op, which was feed for all these different animals. And then it goes around the corner, and on the other side is staging. It's away.
Yeah.
We're not trying to scenic it, although it's been ballasted and it looks really nice over there. It's just away. Okay, that's one leg of the Y. Second leg of the Y goes to Mesa, as you saw as we walked down. And then the third leg of the Y goes that direction, and in actual life, it goes up a grade that never existed. This was surveyed but never built. This was actually built. The Creamery branch still has some track is actually still in place. It's been disconnected at both ends and so forth, but they've just left some of the track. And for all the steel that there is there, I'm surprised somebody hasn't come along
and borrowed it.
I know. Track for the Creamery Ranch. There's still pieces of it still existing, but it really was more extensive at one time. There's a little bit of it, the fact that the part right behind over at the Y has been reconstituted as the light rail.
Okay.
So, but this line up here, the line going to northern Arizona, was surveyed and never built, but we've decided that we went ahead and did. So this section on this side is the branch, and the line climbing, that's the Lost Dutchman main heading north. So, let's look at this branch here, the Kyrene. This is 13th Street, and I need to get it, you know, scenic. We have places where we still have junk on the railroad. It's a work in process, in progress, and then other stuff, you know, gets done. But in real life, the Creamery branch, I mean the Kyrene branch, goes straight south. Now, there's a mirror there. It is a, what do we want to call it, a principle of mirrors. If you can see the edge, it looks like a mirror.
Yeah.
But if we disguise that, it looks like a hole.
Yep.
So we're going to finish disguising that, and we'll have a hole there. But the trackage in real life goes down to about Williams Field Road or so, and
it
stops.
Arizona Avenue now.
Well, that's a conceited term based on a few people in the government down there.
I know.
And since I lived at Williams Field for 5 years, there's a certain connection to me with that
name. And I've actually said the wrong name. It's Chandler Boulevard, not Arizona.
Arizona Avenue goes north and
south. I know,
south.
It meant Chandler. It's one of those.
See what I mean? It's not logical.
Yep.
And besides, it's still Williams Field Road as it goes through Higley.
Yep.
Okay. So the line originally went straight south. Yeah, I should say it the other way around. It came north. They started it at Maricopa and built north to get to Phoenix.
Right.
That line was built in the late 1800s. And they just cut it off when they built the other parts of the access. So because of the wall, we bent it around. So I got this building here to hide the fact that the track is curving through here. So we head around the corner. And this whole side here is a food industry area. Safeway has this high, cheap ground here. And Khalil Bottling has that section over there. It's a big plant. We have all kinds of different spots there. And then we have packaging outfit here, Paulson Packaging. Rosarita has a plant. A1 Brewery has a plant. And the reason for that steep grade is because we're simulating going up onto a hillside. And I had operated at a fellow's layout in Boston by the name of Carlson Flabin. And I have some pictures, but we won't take time to look at them. And he has his arrangement because of a sewer pipe that comes in, and he's got to get up over the sewer pipe, so he's got this really steep grade. And we operated, Dan Thompson and I operated on that layout back a dozen years ago or more, and we really had a great time. So I asked Carl if I could copy that section of his railroad, so he let me. This is a mirror image, and the proportions are changed slightly. This is more spread out to take advantage of the space. But that grade, we had to do some calculations. I took a piece of track on a board and tilted it at various angles to see. What I wanted was to have a grade that required an engine for every two cars. And what I found out was that a 9% grade, you could pull three. So I raised it to 10. That made it two cars. And then just for the heck of it, I went to 11%, and the engine would not stand on the track at 11%. So 10% is the magic number. Above that, you'd have to have a rack locomotive. Mm-hmm. So this is Peterson. And by the way, that's a real name on the Southern Pacific timetables. The SP spells it with an O, Peterson. But the man who settled the area was Niels Peterson, spelled with an E. But, you know, people do that sort of thing. And leaving Peterson, we come to Helena. And this is a chemical operation. And since you're in drama, you'd appreciate if you look at this little piece of paper up here. Does it remind you of anything?
No, not really.
Okay, how about this? You recognize a spinner? You recognize anything there?
He might be before his time.
It might be. It's a 1987 movie. Harrison Ford, Blade Runner. Now does it ring any bells? Okay. That's the Tyrell Pyramid in 1967.
Okay.
Now, later on, he built bigger ones in L.A. But to start with, he was in Tempe, and he built this little one. And he wasn't cloning humans. He was cloning animals.
Yeah.
So we get, at this stock pen here, we get breeder stock hogs, actually, that they select for whatever suitability reasons they have. And then there's a process that goes on in that pyramid, and nobody knows what it is because they have armed guards at all the entrances. So we don't get in there. We deliver the railroad cars, and they do whatever they're going to do. But they have all these chemicals in here They use all sorts of things. And the reason why this is all a jumbled mess with cards standing up, we had a visiting operator come on Wednesday who'd never operated before. And Helena's usually about an hour and a half job. Well, he spent the 3.5 hours and got this far into it.
What do? You got the cards laid out?
Yeah.
All right.
But that's okay. Everybody's got to start someplace.
I screw up a lot, too, so.
All right, then, as you can see, there's the Phoenix Station. The next town is Kyrene itself, and it's still a place. There's the Kyrene School District and Kyrene School and some other things that use the name. And these are actual industries. Kaiser Aluminum, Marathon Steel, Capital Foundry, and Pima Lumber Company. The trackage arrangement is different. It's more linear. You know, they've got long, thin land, and we've got short, squatch ones. But real places. And then this is where Williamsfield Road is going to go, right across here. And by the way, the other names are real ones. It's Kyrene Road here. And that's Galveston Street, which is a real place in Chandler. This little section from here over this funky scenery and the weird plastic trees was salvaged from Ed Ravenscroft's layout. And if you read any of the old magazines, go back and do any research and stuff. Ed was a real instigator for operation back in the 50s and 60s. And when he died, the house was sold, and we looked at what we could salvage out of the railroad. This was the only piece that we could really take intact because it was put on a single piece of material. This town was called Aptakisic, and the way he had it built, each one of these little spurs was a separate industry. Well, that's not as prototypical as you would find most of the time. You would find this would be a single industry with several different spots. So that's the way we treat it. And we're calling it the Aptakisic Artificial Shrub Corporation. And that justifies the plastic trees and all these different things. And then we have Baseline Citrus and other industries that would be in here. This bridge back here was on Ed's Railroad in Chicago back in the 50s. So to have it come back to life again, I feel really proud of the fact that it has been reused that way. This turntable and the roundhouse has been on the cover of Model Railroader twice. This is the original print used to make the magazine cover. Taken with a fisheye lens, and there's the turntable.
Made me for a long time as a little kid want to buy a fisheye lens.
Just for
and then I'm glad I never did. They were expensive at the time.
And not that useful.
I mean, no, I know.
You can do some gimmick shots, and that's kind of about
I've always
it.
Loved that pick cover.
Yeah.
If you see it, you'll know which one it is. It's the only one with the big round circle on it.
The only one. They did that to hope never again.
Yeah, we used our fisheye lens at one time.